Hi, I'm Shannon from Indoor Shannon. Thanks so much for joining me. Today we're going to be talking about how to make our own stylish cape. Let's get started. The first thing we need to do to figure out how to make our own DIY cape is to take some measurements. We're essentially going to be making a circle skirt and using our neck as our waist in the measurement. So begin by finding a tape measure. Grab your tape measure and you want to measure around your neck, but we don't want it to be fitted around our neck. You want it to be where you want the finished garment to be. So mine is a little bit looser. It's sitting down a little bit lower on my neck. And then I want to make sure that I leave enough room to have this cross over. So I'm going to be adding a couple inches to this neck measurement so that I get that full width that's going to cross over the front. So go ahead and write down what your measurement is. You can see my measurement is right around 18 inches. So I'm going to add a couple more inches to that in order to get my full neck opening for my measurement. So let's go with 20 inches for mine. The second thing that we need for our measurement is how long we want our cape. Is go from that neck area where it's going to sit and then measure to where you would like it to end. And go ahead and write that measurement down next. Okay, so now it's time to take those measurements and turn them into a pattern. Begin by taking the neck measurement and divide it by 6.28. Take that measurement and use that to create the top of your circle for your pattern. This is going to be 1/4 of that neck measurement. And the reason that we do that is when we put this on our piece of paper flat and we draw that 1/4 of a circle onto that paper, and then we cut it on the double fold, then when you open it up, obviously you have 4 of those pieces, which creates that circle effect. And that is what we're going for. So I'll show you how to draw that in. And then from that same neck measurement line, you're going to measure down how long you wanted your cape to be. And you're going to mark that all the way going across the pattern as well. Let me show you what it looks like on paper.
Take pieces of paper and mark your neck measurement going around from the corner of one side of your paper. Draw the arc and then go from that neckline measurement down the length that you want your cape. Draw marks all the way around and connect those as well. Now you have your paper pattern. It's time to cut it out. Once you've cut out your paper pattern, when you lay it down on your fabric, you're going to make sure these two sides are both laid on the fold.
So now that you have your pattern created, it's time to get cutting. So let's begin.
If you are using wool for your project, a quick way to pre-shrink it is to get a lot of steam on your iron, lay it flat on a table, and then hover the iron about a half an inch to an inch above, moving all the way around until your fabric is damp, and then just let it completely dry. That will pre-shrink it for you. When it's time to cut out your pattern, you're going to be laying out your lining and your main fabric the same way. The first thing you want to do is fold your fabric in half so that the selvage edges are together. Once you've done that, you're going to take it and fold it in half the other direction. And what that's going to create is a double fold. You'll have 2 folds over here and 2 folds over here. And that's what you're going to use to line up your pattern piece and cut it out. So I'm going to want to adjust my pattern until this edge is on the fold, that double fold, and this one's on the double fold. Our pattern piece is cut out. This next step is optional but recommended. Weight down so nothing shifts. And then I'm just going to go back around that edge one more time, trimming off about a little bit more than 1/8 of an inch, about 1/4 of an inch. And the reason that you do this is when you go to sew this together with your main fabric, it's automatically going to be shorter, and therefore it's going to pull itself naturally towards the lining side, preventing the lining from showing during wear. If you opened up your pattern piece right now, you would see a full circle. If you opened it all the way up, you'd have a circle in the center. What we want to do is leave it folded for now. And while it's folded, we want to go over here to one folded edge, and we want to cut up this folded edge. That's going to become our front opening of our cape. You only want to do that on one edge, otherwise you're going to have too much open. And now we have the beginnings of our cape. Here's our lining piece, and we're going to continue on with the main fabric. So you can just fold back one edge, just cut down one side. Okay, so now you have your main fabric, your lining fabric. Now we want to create our stand collar piece. We're going to begin by opening up that main circle portion of our cape. Next, we want to measure the neck area of our cape. Minus 23 inches. Write that measurement down. Okay, next we want to determine the height of our collar. This is going to be a personal preference. I want to have a 3-inch tall finished collar when I'm done. So because I'm going to be cutting it both from the main fabric and the lining, I need to add a whole inch to it for seam allowances along the top and along the bottom where I am attaching it. I'm going to cut mine at 4 inches tall by the neck width opening. Now, my drafting paper is not going to be long enough for 23 inches by 4 inches tall. So instead, I'm just going to do this in half and cut it on the fold. So now I'm going to cut out my pattern piece. I'm going to place that on the fold of the fabric and cut. Okay, you should now have 3 color pieces, your lining, your main fabric, and your interfacing. You should have your mane of your cape and the lining of your cape. And now it's time to begin construction. We want to begin by prepping our collar. I'm going to be taking the wool piece, and on the back side, I'm going to be putting the sticky side, which is the shinier side when you're working with interfacing, down. And we want to go ahead and press this on. Now, I prepped my wool by steaming it lightly so that any shrinkage would occur. You'll want to go ahead and make sure your fabric has been prepped as well. Once your interfacing has cooled and you make sure it's fully attached, you're going to take this main piece of your collar and lie it right sides up and lay your lining fabric right sides down so that the right sides are facing. And now you want to take it to your machine, and using a 1/2 inch seam allowance, you're going to sew around the 2 short sides and up through the middle. If you want to make sure that you're not getting any stretching on your collar, one way is to start in the middle of the top of the collar, stitch out and down, then come back to this point and out and down. This will help prevent any stretching from happening. I have the collar pinned down one side. I'm going to start at approximately the center of that collar, and using a straight stitch on my machine, I just have it at a 2.5 length. Back stitch. I'm just going to stitch down this long side. Put the needle down in it and turn my fabric and finish stitching down the short edge. There's the stitching for one side, and now I'm just gonna flip it over and do the same thing going this way. Okay, so we've now stitched our collar, and it's time to trim this down for the bulk. We're gonna layer this seam by taking our lining fabric and cutting it quite a bit shorter than our outer fabric. So I'm just gonna first take that lining fabric and cut it about half of it off. So trim it down to about a quarter inch. And now I just want to trim that back seam allowance down a little bit to reduce the bulk. Not quite as short as what I just did. We're going to be taking this and flipping out the corners. I like to use the wooden skewer from a tube turner just to help ease that out. Mine really wants to roll out, so I'm going to give it a good press here to hold it down, but in addition I might run an understitch on this side where you're just going to stitch one eighth of an inch away on the lining side of the seam and make sure that all the seam allowances are pressed up towards that lining side, and then this will help when we do turn it to press it that those aren't going to want to roll back forward. So my collar just really didn't want to cooperate. It's really wanting to roll back on itself. So I went ahead and put in a layer of understitching here just to help. And then I think once it's attached onto the actual cape, it will be better. So what we're going to do next is take our main cape and we want to lay it out with the right sides up. And we want to put our collar on it with right sides facing. So I want on mine the black to the black. So we want to find the center of our collar. I'm just going to fold it in half and put a clip there. In the center of your neckline. Now in my heavier wool fabric that has some stretch, my neckline may have stretched here slightly without putting in stay stitching. So that's why I'm going to use this method, but it should be coming in for about a half an inch to an inch on those side seams. So we're just going to kind of ease that in, match up those collars, and make sure that we're happy with where it's going to come together. Okay, now we're going to take that to our machine. And using a half inch seam allowance, we're going to stitch the collar onto the neck of the main cape. Okay, we've now sewn our collar to our main cape. You want to lay this out on the table and go ahead and cut in some notches all the way around to just help the fabric release and so that it's going to take the shape of the collar better. Clipped all the way around. You can see these clips are going to spread. We're going to take our lining fabric for the cape. We want to lie that right sides down, right on top, sandwiching in the collar so that it's in between the two pieces of fabric. We want to match our necklines up and pin them together. Okay, so we have it clipped all the way together, and now I'm just going to take it to the machine. I'm going to follow that stitching line that I already made before and just go slightly past it to make sure I'm catching it, but I want to stay mostly at a half an inch. So if I can, I'm just going to try to go right along the top of that same stitching line. Check it. I have a couple little puckers here that I think I want to fix. So I'm probably going to pull those stitches and fix them before I go on. If you need to fix an area, just go back to where you see that little pucker and pick out using a seam ripper. And I pick out about a half inch to an inch on either side of that pucker. Now I'm going to be able to smooth it out a little bit better, and I'm going to restitch it from my collar. There isn't the pucker in the lining now. So we now have the lining sewn in and we have that collar sandwiched, and we want to take a pausing point here. And the reason is because if you're using a heavier fabric like I am, this wool or anything really that's going to be cut a little bit here on the bias like a circle skirt, you're going to want to let it hang for 24 hours to let anything potentially release or fall, because if you go and do all of this finishing now and hem it, you may find that it's going to stretch over time and then your seams are going to just be not good, or your hems are just not going to be good. So I'm going to put mine and drape it over my dress form just like it will be worn. You can kind of see how it's coming together here. Very chic. But you could also hang it on a hanger if you don't have a dress form or anything else. And I'm just going to leave it be for 24 hours. I'm going to come back and check and make sure that this is still a nice straight hem at the edge. If you had anything that stretched out or got out of shape, go ahead and trim it off now before we continue on. The next part of the process is going to be to enclose our lining fully to finish off the bottoms and also the front side seams. So what I want to do on mine is I'm going to come in about a half an inch on these front side seams so that I can still overlap this when being worn. I want my neck to slightly overlap. That's just my preference. So you can choose to either finish your collar point right at the same as your front seam and make that your seam allowance, but I'm just going to go over a half an inch. So here's how we're going to do this. Okay, so now it's time to do the side seams and the bottom hem. So what we're going to do is we're going to flip our cape back, wrong sides out, matching up your front seams, center seams, and then your lining to your bottom hem. And then we're going to start pinning or clipping. I'm going to be doing a half an inch seam allowance here and at the bottom. And you basically want to pin or clip all the way around, leaving yourself about a 10 inch opening here at one of the bottom areas so that we can turn our poncho right side out through that opening. So I like to mark mine and kind of do it over here a little bit to one side. Some people like to do it in the center back. It's really up to you where you want to mark yours, but to do that, a simple way to mark it so you don't forget is just to put a double clip where you want to stop and start stitching. And this will just help be a visual reminder that this area is to be left unsewn. So go ahead and pin or clip all the way around except for that opening. Okay, now that's all fixed up, I'm going to go ahead and do a half inch seam allowance all the way around with the exception of that area that I want to remain open. Make sure you backstitch at the beginning and the end of your stitches. Okay, now you just want to go back through and trim your corners and any bulk seam allowance down. Don't want to trim down the seam allowance here where my opening is. It will just make it easier to flip and fold that under if I leave it longer. So I'm going to ignore that area. You're going to reach in to where you left open, and I like to start at the opposite corner and grab it and then start pulling it right side out. Now we left plenty large of an opening, you could make that smaller. This will make it very easy to turn. Quick work of that. All right, and this is how it should start to look. Then you want to go back to your corners. You can reach your hand and go in through your openings. Push those corners out. You could also use your turner here, tube turner. Come back to this side. Push those corners out. And we're almost done with the cape. So now all of your edges are finished off except for your opening. You want to take it to your iron and making sure that, I find it easier to do this with the lining side up. You're going to take it to your iron and you just want to roll back that lining edge towards the lining side just slightly. So about a fourth of an inch of the wool is showing. And you want to give this a nice press all the way around. This is going to take some time, and you want to press that bottom edge, doing the same thing, making sure it's slightly rolled up towards you along the bottom. So go ahead and press your whole thing well now. Now the next step is optional, but highly recommended. We're going to go back now, and we are going to top stitch. And this is going to help secure our lining in place to hold it towards the inside. And it's also going to close this opening that we left to turn it right side out. To do the prep work here, I just pressed mine up so that it matched the rest of the hemline. And I'm gonna take it to my machine. I'm gonna keep the red thread on my top and my black thread on the bobbin. And then that way I can kind of blend in those two colors while I do my top stitching all the way around again. All right, now it's time to try it on. I have it all top stitched. Here we go. So you're gonna wanna try it on yourself just so you can see where you wanna put your closures on. I want mine to wrap around and over my neck like that so that it's a little more fitted around the neckline. You certainly don't have to bring it over this far. You could just close it together here, wherever you want it to be. So go ahead and try it on now and determine where you want your cape to close. Now that you have your cape on, it's going to be time to mark this overlap. This is going to show where you want to attach your snaps to hold this closed. And this can be kind of difficult to do on yourself. You could take a piece of chalk and just draw on the black fabric and mark where that line will be, but I'm actually going to use pins, and I'm just putting a couple pins here to show where the overlap is going to stop, and that's going to help me determine where to put my snaps. So I was looking for these sew-on snaps that are a little bit larger in size, a little bit more heavy duty. One, my fabric is quite thick and quite heavy. But I also want to do these snaps because I want it to be hidden from the outside. You're going to want to sew one snap part onto the under collar part that's not going to show, and then one on the collar that's going to come over, and make sure that you're matching where they go so that when it snaps together, it will be completely hidden underneath the cape. And you could be done at this point.
And there you have it. We made our own DIY cape. Wasn't that so much fun? Thank you so much for joining me for this tutorial. Make sure you like and subscribe to see more like it. And I will link in the description below the full tutorial if you want to see more pictures or see the written out instructions. Until next time, happy sewing!